So look, as you know, I'm a degenerate piece of shit, and I invest almost exclusively in microcaps and lower cap coins. I don't own a single coin above $1 billion market cap, and people think I'm crazy for that. But in my opinion, it's actually not that risky, and it's so much easier to make a lot of money in microcaps if you know what you're looking at. And the edge I have in crypto is look, I can't do a DeFi protocol. I can't read a DeFi protocol. I don't understand that stuff well enough to say this is bad and this is good consistently. There's no way I can look at a microcap DeFi protocol gem or an insurance gem or something like that and say, okay, this one is definitely going to make it. That being said, I've been in business for about a decade, and I also deeply, deeply understand game marketing and game development. And so my edge in crypto is I don't invest in crypto. I invest in businesses and businesses that are ran well. As soon as I started doing that, it became significantly easier for me to consistently make money in microcaps because, again, most cryptos don't know anything about business. They don't know anything about marketing. They don't know how companies are ran. They don't know how teams are built. They just know crypto. And so I don't try to play to their strengths, which is knowing DeFi protocols and all the currencies and whatnot. I play to my strengths, which is understanding how businesses are set up. And because of that, I'm able to find a lot of things way earlier than other cryptos are because I'm not a crypto. I'm an entrepreneur. So I invest in entrepreneurs, if you're picking up the drift that I'm saying right now. So there's a lot of gems that I'm able to find that other people are just gonna completely miss because they're looking at it in a crypto sense. I look at it in a software and an entrepreneur sense. And so in this video, I'm gonna share you with you perhaps the easiest investing strategy and show you a few coins that I'm invested in a whole lot. Not to pump them, but to give you really good examples. Because it's just so damn frustrating for me to see people ignoring some of these coins and looking over them when these are gonna be the coins that make so much money and it's such an easy call. So that also being said, follow me on Twitter at ZSS Becker because I do talk about these things a lot earlier. And I want to stress in this video, I am not telling you to buy these coins. I'm absolutely not telling you to buy these coins. I am telling you to use this thought process I used to find these coins, to find your own coins. If you are buying things based on when an influencer tells you to buy things, you are late to the party and the definition of a groupthink mentality, which gets you slaughtered in crypto. So just don't do it, okay? So let's look at this real quick. So look guys, everybody hates me for saying stuff like this, and that's okay because I hate you right back if this triggers you and you're an emotional baby. But I think if you're investing in the top 25, I think you're kind of an idiot because you're inheriting all this risk for just no real upside. Now, I know people are gonna think like, oh, 5X, 8X upside. Yeah, that's great. But if you have $1,000 and you're trying to make, I don't know, hundreds of thousands of dollars, it's gonna be extremely difficult to do it in these coins. It just simply is. And I'm in crypto, just straight up, I'm gonna be honest with you, to make tens of millions of dollars while taking small risk. I have no interest in being in something like, I don't know, Solana, and putting in a large amount of my money. Let's say if I want to make $10 million on Solana, I'm probably have to put $1 million in it. I'm not interested in holding $1 million in a single coin where the market can just blow up tomorrow. It's just how crypto is. And I know people think, okay, Alex, well, we're going to see a massive bull run lead up. I don't know if we're going to see that. I just simply don't. I'm hopeful for it. I believe that we're going up for the rest of the year, but I really don't know. And if you guys have seen my Bitcoin calls, this unpredictable as hell. I'm sorry, it just is. And if you think it is, and if you think you can just sit here and call this all day, you really can't. And so my investment thesis and strategy is I find businesses, games, extremely early on based on their teams, the people inside them, and the fundamentals of the businesses. Because in crypto, and especially blockchain, there are so many fundamental problems in business and entrepreneurship that are just simply not solved online. Now, I'm not looking for things that banks are going to run on. I'm not looking for something that is going to change countries and allow the unbanked to be banked and freedom money and all that dumb shit. What I look for is businesses that I would start. What I look for is good old-fashioned businesses that have a product that is gonna sell to customers and businesses that are built well around the team. What I instead look for is I understand online business marketing and software very, very well. And I understand the problems in those spaces very, very well. There's tons of problems when it comes to file storage or security, deploying files, running your software, tracking, the list goes on and on. I know about this all day long because this is what I do for a living. Whereas most crypto investors do, I don't know what the hell they do all day on Twitter. I don't know why half of them invest in these coins. I'm just being frank with you. Because if you invest in all these coins right here in this top 100, all you're really doing is following group mentality. You're the definition of a follower. I'm not trying to be rude. That's what you're doing. You're following what everybody else is investing in. Because in reality, no one's really using a lot of these coins. These valuations are bonkers. They just simply are. I'm not trying to be a dick, and you can make money doing this. And if you have, wonderful for you, but these valuations are just based on FOMO and hype. And these coins are big because they're big, because everybody else is invested in them. Again, I know these are going to be the future and DeFi and all that kind of stuff. I'm not saying that's going to happen. I'm just saying you're following what other people are doing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use my own head to find these coins. So for example, let me just give you a brilliant example of this. Again, I'm not telling you to buy this coin right here. Okay, so this is one of my favorite coins, ColdStack. Why do I invest in ColdStack, and why am I just extremely comfortable holding this? So I find businesses that I know are going to work eventually. Okay, eventually these products are going to come to market, and regardless of what Bitcoin is doing and what all the FOMO and crazy stuff is going on in Twitter and hype is, regardless if we're in a bull or bear market, file storage is an issue. It's a significant issue, and I use AWS every single day at my business. And so for example, ColdStack uses blockchain to get a significantly lower bill. So for example, if my business is spending $40,000, $50,000 per month to store files, well, ColdStack can cut that bill down to $25,000. What product do you think I'm going to be using at Hyros? It's that damn simple. And so what I do is I go and find businesses like this, and they're usually in the gutter. You can see the price of ColdStack is very low right now. And again, I'm not telling you to invest in this. It has a diluted market cap that is actually rather high. And I got into this extremely early. So again, I'm not telling you to pump my bags. I'm telling you to shut up and listen. So what I do is I find businesses like this that have a product that I know is going to come to market and I know is going to work based on my experience in business and software and file storage and tracking and whatnot. And a lot of times they have really bad prices because cryptos don't understand business. This isn't a dig at cryptos. They can read protocols and they can do all sorts of stuff that I have no understanding of, okay? I cannot really tell you why XRP is gonna change the world. I can't tell you the Flare network is gonna work. Everybody has their forte. My forte is, again, understanding business and the problems online businesses have. And because most cryptos can't do that, these coins are constantly overlooked. There's no shortage of people that understand DeFi and crypto. There's an extreme shortage of people that have business sense in crypto or understand online and digital business. A lot of these people in crypto have never started a business before, and they've been working in these protocols and whatnot forever. What I then do when I see types of products like this is I go and talk to the team and I go and research the product. A lot of these are startups where you can actually go and talk to the team even if you're a small investor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go and find companies that solve problems that my business literally has. For example, ColdStack solves a lot of processing issues and high cost issues. So once I go and find these businesses, I'm going to go talk to the team and I'm going to look at the business itself. I'm going to look at the website. I'm going to check the fonts. I'm going to look at the branding. Why? Because branding, fonts, and consistency in business matter. Okay. If you go into a business and you got misspelling, you got weird stuff all over the place, you don't have good branding and marketing, probably not going to make it, because marketing and branding matter when we're actually talking about real products. So I'm going to go look at the roadmap and see when they're going to be releasing their product and when it's probably going to come to market. If I see a product that I know is going to work in the marketplace and I see a good team, I see good marketing and branding. And then what I also go in is I go and talk to the team to investigate their culture, how they're hiring, how they're talking to their employees, how they manage investors, all that jazz. I go and research what they've done before, their experience in business, everything they've built. And by doing this and not looking on the crypto side of things, but looking at things on the business and software and SaaS side of things, I'm able to find a lot of gems that just most people aren't going to see. And I'm able to hold them quite comfortably. Because again, if we go bear or bull, it doesn't matter when CloudStack comes to the marketplace. If I'm spending $50,000 a month at AWS, I'm going to say, hey guys, why don't we just like not do that and spend $25,000 a month here? Or if I see a way to improve tracking with blockchain, or I see a way to improve the security of my site or the login functionality, the list goes on, the security behind info products and digital products online. If I see that type of opportunity right there, that's when I go and invest and I just hold these things because I know the product's gonna come to market and it's not based on the crypto market. I wanted to share that strategy with you. If you're getting into crypto, my advice to you is I know a lot of entrepreneurs and people have experience in business, find things in your life, find problems that you are very well aware of, and then find crypto companies that solve those, because most people don't think like that when they're investing in crypto. And this is a very easy, straightforward way to make a lot of money in microcaps without taking that much risk, because you're buying these things when they're already super duper low. And it's a business that's eventually going to come to market. Just make sure it has a good team, good people behind it, and they're actually bringing a product to market. And you're going to have a way better shot of 10x, 50xing your money than swinging your dick around in the top 50 coins, which you could go down at any time. And then everybody's already in. And the returns are going to be lower because everybody's already in them. If you were following people, if you were buying something in the top 25, you are very late to the damn party. Why not find parties where you're early? I don't get why people are obsessed with these top 25 coins. I'm not interested in making a 5x in crypto with all this risk. I'm interested in making a lot of money while taking smaller risk. That's my strategy. That's what I do. I just wanted to share this with you guys because I don't see people doing it. It frustrates the hell out of me because it's so damn common sense. And this has made me a lot of money in crypto and microcaps without me really feeling uncomfortable or like I'm taking massive risks. Like Coltstech is very easy for me to invest in, and other businesses that I've made a lot of money in, same exact thing. Same thing with gaming crypto as well. I use my experience in game dev and game marketing and understanding how teams are built and how companies are built to find really good games that most people are gonna overlook because everybody looks in the hype and FOMO and nonsense when they're investing in gaming cryptos, which is, that's not how you invest in them. You invest in teams, people, and the marketing strategies behind them and the actual proc they're bringing to market. Most people don't do that in crypto. So use that and you're gonna have a big edge. I have nothing more to add. I just wanted to get this kind of rant out so you could look at it. If you want to see coins I'm investing in a lot earlier, follow me on Twitter at CSSBecker. I don't have anything else to say.